Welcome, and I'm John Redman from Horizon Hobby. Sitting here today with my buddy Matt Andren from the ParkZone development team. Matt, how are you doing?
Doing good.
Hey, today we're bringing you a great new Ultra Micro, a first from the ParkZone team. It's a twin, okay? Most people would have thought probably B25 Matt, and if you know Matt, let me tell you, this guy, if there was ever an airplane designed or developed that they only made one or two of, you pretty much know what it is.
Probably pretty close, yeah.
You love that obscure stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Now, the Mossy's not that obscure.
No, it's pretty well known, truthfully.
And so let's just kind of question, my curiosity here, why a Mossy?
Well, you know, looking at, you know, the other popular choices like a B-25,
right.
When you start really digging into the airplane, you realize that some things are a little tricky about it, like the making the dual rudders work and a
good
few
point.
Other things. So, you know, we looked at something that was maybe not as well modeled out there in the RC community and thought, you know, a Mosquito is a perfect twin subject matter. It's got, you know, a single rudder, so it makes hooking up your controls very easy, good tail moments, nice lines, and we thought we could make it fly really nice. And so we went at it and really happy with the results. So
history sits in front of us.
There you go.
So there it is. It all comes down to the initial design of the airplane, the real one. Now, you did this when most model airplanes always made of balsa wood.
Right.
All our Ultra Micros are made of foam.
Right.
But what's really interesting is the full-scale Mossy is made of?
Balsa wood and plywood.
There you go. So we're kind of regressing a little bit here
from the design world. Yeah.
So you're not totally true to scale. But
not
we'll
exactly,
let you go
not exactly.
So that's pretty awesome. Now, a number of notable features on this that have basically been a direction and a change. One, the clear canopy. First in the Ultra Micros from ParkZone, right?
Absolutely. And, you know, it just really gives that whole new level of depth to the airplane and just makes it look a lot more realistic in the air.
Right. The other one, of course, with the twin engines, you guys had to come up with a whole new receiver board.
Yes, we did. It is the AR6400T. It is a twin brushed output speed control. They're basically synced together, so when the battery hits low voltage cutoff, both motors will stop at the same time, so that way you don't have an engine out situation as the battery gets depleted. So makes flying great. They're counter-rotating props, so there's really no torque to worry about. You can gun it and go, and it tracks nice and straight.
Right.
You don't have to worry about any torque effects.
And, you know, we could sit down and pick it up here and kind of take a look. Everyone out there knows the batteries always go on the bottom.
Right.
There's no battery hole.
Not in this one.
And this is what's pretty cool, folks. Matt sat down and decided to hide the battery. Magnetic front hatch here. Basically, the whole cannon nose. And a battery slips right in there, Matt.
Yep, it's a brand new battery as well. It's a 250 milliamp hour single cell 20C battery. Slips right in there, really easy access. Works great in the airplane. Really gives it a good bit of power, a good punch for climbouts and everything.
That's awesome. Now, how much flight time will we get with that battery?
Truthfully, you'll see about probably 6 to 8 minutes, depending on how hard you are in the throttle. If you're cruising around full throttle the whole time, you're going to be more around the 6 minute mark. If you're doing touch and goes, doing some nice gentle scale flight, you might even be able to extend it up to about 10 minutes. So.
Okay. And another note is we know you, all the ultra micro airplanes out there, you plug the landing gear in.
Right.
But on like the P-51, the T-28, they got a little clip.
And right.
If you don't have the fingernail,
it
can be a little tough.
It can be tricky at times,
These, on the other hand, not so much.
Just friction fit, pop out just that easy.
Simple and easy, and now you have got really a killer-looking Mossy to fly around and enjoy.
Oh, yeah, and it just looks great doing the low passes with the gear off. Nothing beats it.
Right. So now, we also learned out there, landing gear on, landing gear off, trim changes.
Yes.
Talk to us a little bit about that, Matt.
Yeah, because of the large wheels and how far they are mounted below the airplane, in flight they tend to produce a bit of drag, and since it's all below the airplane, the air hits it and wants to push the nose down.
Trying to pull it down a little bit.
So with the gear on, it takes a couple clicks up trim. When you remove the gear, now all of a sudden you have to give a couple clicks of down trim to prevent that. So just maybe 4 or 5 clicks of trim difference from gear on to gear off.
Right. Awesome. Now, other noticeable differences, or notable differences, I guess we could say, is inside on the prop shafts. Now, Matt invited me out to do some flight testing on this, you know, and I'd done it outside, indoor, and we're indoors having a good time, and he tells me to pour the power to it, and lo and behold, one of the props slings across the room, and the plane spins in. I'm like, yeah, thanks for setting me up and such. And what you found was the threads. Yeah. You had to make a new shaft.
Right, with the counter-rotating prop, basically the motor was trying to unthread the propeller in flight.
Every
and eventually,
time you plug the power.
Exactly, and you know, if you happen to nick the prop, it could just knock it loose enough that the next flight would spin it off. So we did a reverse thread on the counter-rotating prop, which works fantastic.
Excellent, so. Excellent. So technically, there are two shafts, a left and a right.
Correct.
If you need to sit
correct.
Down, and that's...
And they are offered together in a right. package, so if you need one, they're easily labeled and identifiable as a left and a right, so it makes it very easy to replace or repair if you need be.
Right. Okay, so killer airplane, but Charger looks a little different.
It is.
It's white.
It's a new Charger for us as well. And this Charger is able to use 6-volt or 12-volt input power. So if you have you know, your AC wall adapter from your 4-port E-Flight Charger,
right.
works in this great. If you want to have a 12-volt power source, it comes with the alligator clips. You just plug it right into that. So you got a number of options for powering this Charger. So it's a very versatile little Charger, easy to transport, carry with you in your flight box.
Right.
Don't have to carry your really nice Charger around with you.
So the big key here is the white one.
Yes.
Is 6 and 12 volt input capable.
Right.
The old black one.
Tandem rescue charger.
Tandem rescue charger.
6 volt only.
6 volt
yep.
only.
Yep.
Okay, so that's why they changed the color. Got them in your box. And I mean, it's even labeled here, but if you're a modeler like me, I don't always read that stuff. So that's why they help color code it. So that's pretty awesome, Matt. I mean, looking at it, I'm just loving the Mosquito. Great job. Future twins. If this goes out and hits real well, maybe we could see another one someday?
Very possible. There's a lot of airplanes out there that are would be good modeling candidates, and we're always keeping our eyes open.
Yeah, I'm thinking B-17. Push the wingspan out a little bit. Dude, it'd be rocking.
It's getting out of the ultra-micro land there a little
no,
bit.
No, it's not. Come on. You know? Anyways, hey, guys, the ParkZone Ultra-Micro Mosquito shipping this week?
Probably pretty close, yeah, within
so
a week. So
it's here.
Yep.
It's here. In fact, this is one of the actual QA samples.
Yes.
You flew yesterday to
yep.
verify to say go ahead and ship the product. So
you got it.
It's here. It's now. Right here from Matt Andren and the ParkZone team. Killer, killer Ultra Micro Mosquito. Get yours today. Hey, by the way, check it out at your local hobby shop. Nothing there. Drop by horizonhobby.com. Help you out in both places. And if any of you ever have a question, remember you can find me at editors@horizonrc.com. Take care.